The grand theme of the 21st century is the rise of artificial intelligence, which is going to transform every aspect of our civilization. The human brain has about 10 billion neurons, and each of them is connected to about 10,000 other neurons on average, which means that you've got about 100,000 billion connections in this brain, and all your lifelong experience is encoded somehow in the strengths of these connections in the synapses. And these connection strengths, they change through learning over time, and in our artificial recurrent neural networks, the same thing is happening. Over time, these connections, which are initially random, they learn through experience to deal with all kinds of incoming data streams, such as video, and then produce classifications of these videos. So machine learning is about machines that are not pre-programmed to solve some problem, but that instead these machines somehow learn through experience, through trial and error, or through human instructors who show them how to do it and they imitate the humans. Many people don't realize that in their daily lives they are already in contact with artificial intelligence and artificial neural networks. For example, on your smartphones you have a dictate function. When you don't want to type, then you speak to the smartphone. And the best systems for recognizing what you're saying, they are using artificial neural networks. In particular, something that is called long short-term memory, or LSTM. Long short-term memory is a particular type of recurrent neural network with feedback connections, which allow the network to store events that were observed a while ago, such that the whole system can deal with sequences, such that it can recognize speech or recognize what's happening in videos. Every decade, computers are getting 100 times faster per British pound. In the rather near future, for the first time, we will have rather small computational devices, rather cheap, which can compute as much as a human brain. In terms of raw computational power, we don't have that yet, but it will probably arrive soon. And then, if the trend doesn't break down, within 5 more decades, for the first time, we will have, for the same price, small machines that can compute as much as all human brains combined, as all 10 billion brains combined. So how is artificial intelligence going to change your lives in the next few years? One super important application is medical imaging, where you have images that depict cells of the human body, and the doctor, a trained histologist, for example, wants to figure out which of these cells are in pre-cancer stage. And then we train our artificial networks to recognize these dangerous cells, which means that the human doctor suddenly can treat many patients with the same quality and the same time that he needed for only one single patient before. At the moment, most self-driving cars use rather standard methods where you rely a lot on GPS and precise maps of the streets. But it is possible, in principle, to use these artificial neural networks to learn to drive like a human based on vision, where you recognize the dangerous situations like humans. My kids were born around the turn of the millennium, which means that a substantial fraction of their lives they will spend in a world where the most important and smartest decision makers won't be human anymore. It will be exciting to see where artificial intelligence is going to take humankind.